Hello, welcome back. Today I'm going to be briefly talking about 15 great modern prog albums. The reason I'm doing this was a couple of reasons. I just thought it would be fun, one reason, and another one is I probably am a bit of a classicist when it comes to prog. I have a lot of problems with quite a lot of the modern prog bands. I think a lot of them kind of like copy other bands from the 70s. And they don't really do anything new. But this is also for anyone who considers themselves a classicist, hasn't really ventured into modern prog at all. And if you want to get into any modern prog, again, there are maybe one or two albums on this list that a lot of people may not consider prog. There may not be actually classed as prog, but it's more kind of my definition of what prog is. And like, I think prog's more based on experimentation and sort of complexity than song lengths and keyboard solos and things like that. I won't be talking about any Iron Maiden albums, even though I consider their modern stuff progressive metal, because again, that's a debatable whether they're prog or not, and I thought I'd just leave them out. They're my favorite band anyway. And another quick thing, there aren't any Flower Kings albums on this list. The reason for that is I do like the Flower Kings, but I couldn't name a Flower Kings album that's really brilliant from start to finish. I think they have a bunch of great songs, but apart from maybe Adam and Eve, maybe back in the worlds of adventure, there I can't really name a Flower Kings album that's really brilliant from start to finish. I mean, even then they're a bit of a stretch. They have, like I said, they have a lot of brilliant songs, but I can't really name an album that's brilliant from start to finish. So I've left the Flower Kings out, but they have loads and loads of great songs. My favorite's Numbers. Anyway, I've got 15 albums to talk about, so I'll just get straight on with it. One more rule. One rule is there aren't any modern albums of bands from the 70s. So this is all modern prog bands. Well, I'd say modern, maybe from the bands that released their first albums in the 80s or the late 80s onwards. So there won't be any Rush, no King Crimson, no Vanagraph Generator, no ELP, yes, Pink Floyd, none of that. So there won't be Clockwork Angels, there won't be On an Island, no Power to Believe, no modern albums of classic prog bands. It's all just totally new bands or from the 80s anyway, which, I mean, that's even debatable as well, because classic prog is it's debatable where ends and where modern prog starts. I'd probably say somewhere in the mid 80s. So anyway, first album, Sounds That Can't Be Made by Marillion, released in 2012. I'm probably cheating a wee bit here because Marillion are quite old. They've been about since the early 80s, but I thought I'd put it in because it came out in 2012 and it's a fantastic album. I've already reviewed it. It's my favourite Marillion album, and it has some of the best songs, some of the best modern prog songs ever, like Gaza, Sounds That Can't Be Made, and there's some quite easygoing stuff for the ones that aren't into kind of more hardcore prog stuff. It's just one of my all-time favorite albums, to be honest. And if I hadn't liked this album, because I think this was the second or third Marillion album that I listened to, I think if I hadn't bought this as the second or third album, I probably would have never have heard it, because the first couple that I heard I didn't really like. So I'm glad I'd listened to this one. That's kind of made me persevere more with Marillion. Next, Kid A by Radiohead. That's another one I've reviewed, released in 2000. That's another one that's debatable whether it's even prog or not. I consider Kid A to be very progressive. It's experimental, it's got complex time signatures, it's got all the prog elements are there. There's just no 20-minute songs or keyboard solos. So say what you will, but Kid A is it's one of the best albums ever. It kind of goes without saying. It's such a fantastic album. I already reviewed it. Some amazing songs like the title track and Limbo, I absolutely love the national anthem. It's got loads of different sort of musical styles in that, and to me that's kind of what prog's about. Next, Stranger Heads Prevail by Thank You Scientist. This is a band I haven't actually mentioned yet. This is the only album of theirs I've heard, even though I think they've only done about two or three. They're very modern. They actually released their first album this decade, so they're very modern. It's a very jazzy, lots of trumpets and lots of saxophone if you're into that kind of like jazzy, but there's kind of metal as well. So if you're into kind of like jazz metal but there's nothing too difficult to listen to, I'd say. There's nothing too out there. It's quite easy to listen to. They're good. They're a very good band, and I really, really enjoy this album. Definitely give it a listen. Next, Francis the Mute by the Mars Volta. Especially the first track, Cygnus, Vismund Cygnus, is fantastic. 13-minute track. I also enjoy At the Drive-In. Mars Volta were kind of one of the modern prog bands that it took me a while to get into. After it took me a while to buy one of their albums. I got into bands like Transatlantic way before this, and then I finally got around to buying Francis the Mute, and I enjoyed it. Though I would personally say I enjoy their first album more. Cygnus, Vismund Cygnus is my favourite song of theirs, so I would go to this album just because it has my favourite song of theirs. It's absolutely fantastic, and the other songs on it are good as well. It's just I absolutely love that first track. Next, Dimension Up by Sound of Contact. This, if you haven't heard of them, Sound of Contact, I think they've only done one album, and I think they've already split up. Simon Collins, Phil Collins' son, actually sings on this album, and it's very like kind of like what you consider to be very proggy, even though Phil Collins kind of abandoned prog, like over maybe 40 years ago. His son seemed very into it, and this is a very proggy album. There's nothing that's like Vanagraph Generator levels of prog, but it's kind of like, I guess it's kind of the kind of thing Genesis would maybe be doing nowadays if they'd started now. Quite easy to listen to in most parts. But my favorite track on it's the finale, the 19-minute finale, Mobius Slip. Absolutely brilliant. But it really is one of those albums that's great from start to finish. Definitely give this one a listen. Next, Mastodon, Crack the Sky. They're not my favorite progressive metal band, Mastodon, but they're the first one I ever got into. I actually got into Mastodon before I got into prog. I got into heavy metal like 6 or 7 years before I got into prog. I've loved metal since I was a kid. So I used to like watch the music channels on TV and see metal bands, and I absolutely loved the Mastodon songs that were on there, like Curl of the Barrel, Blood and Thunder, songs like that. And then it wasn't until a few years ago I actually realized that they're actually prog, and if you kind of go past the singles and you listen to the Blood and Thunder, it does have complex sort of parts in it. If you go past the singles and listen to the kind of lengthier songs, they're very progressive, and this is definitely their best album. The two best songs are definitely The Last Baron and The Tsar, both 10, 13 minutes long. The Last Baron especially, I think is absolutely fantastic. So it's great that a band like Mastodon can have like so many different sides to their music. Next album is Waterfall Cities by Osric Tentacles. Personal favourite Osric Tentacles album. I've talked about them before. I've talked about how underrated they are, how they're one of the absolute best bands ever, but they're underrated. This was released in 1999, and it is so good. Very electronic. There's some EDM in here as well, but it's so experimental. It's complex. It's beautiful, just like most of their music. But this is my personal favorite. There's just something about it that I absolutely love. Every track's fantastic. It's absolutely beautiful from start to finish, and I just love it. Next, don't really know how to pronounce this, but Teria by Devin Townsend, who I'm going to see next month, and I'm very excited about that. Like a lot of Devin Townsend fans, probably Deadhead was the first one I heard. Absolutely loved it, but I would, which was on the Accelerated Evolution album, but I would actually say Teria is a better album all around. Ones like Olives and Mountain are fantastic introduction to the album. It's very heavy, but I'm not really into his more extreme metal stuff that he kind of did with the Devin Townsend project like Deconstruction. I'm much more into this kind of stuff. It's very melodic at times as well, and I think that's when he's at his best, when he has a mixture of the melodic side of the music and the very heavy side. But it's such a good album. Absolutely love it. Next, Sailing the Seas of Cheese by Primus. I guess this is another one that's debatable whether Primus are actually prog or not. Well, they've got the complex time signatures, they've got the experimental nature of their music, they've got the, you know, when you listen to them, you know they're not a they're not like a regular band. So I guess that ticks the boxes for me. It's actually the only Primus album I own, even though I do like quite a lot of their other stuff that I haven't actually bought yet. I've heard them on like the internet. But this has got lots of great songs like 11, Jerry Was a Race Car Driver, Sergeant Baker, American Life, those damn blue collar tweakers. It's their highest rated album as well, that's why I bought it first, and it's understandable why. It's really good from almost from start to finish. Loads and loads of good songs on it. Next, Sleeping in Traffic Part 2 by Beardfish. This was released in 2008, and this is an album that I liked on the first listen, but it took me a while to really, really get into it and really, really appreciate it. On the first listen, I absolutely loved the downward spiral and Chimay, if I'm pronouncing that right. But after lots of listens, I absolutely love the Sleeping in Traffic 35-minute behemoth towards the end of the album. It's amazing. It really, really is. It's not as good as Close to the Edge or something like that, but it is absolutely fantastic. And it is one of those albums that is almost brilliant from start to finish. And in fact, every song on it's good. So I definitely give this one a listen. They're quite comedic as well. I wouldn't say they're a comedy band. They're not like Tenacious D or anything, but there's definitely their funny moments. So they have quite a lot of personality. Next, these are in no particular order, by the way, but I left these last because I have them on vinyl, so it's just easier to put the vinyls at the bottom. Bridge Across Forever by Transatlantic. Like I said, one album per band, so Bridge Across Forever was probably the first modern prog album I ever loved. Because of Stranger in Your Soul, I listened to that and I absolutely loved it. And modern prog does have a different sound to it, definitely, than classic prog. And when you first hear modern prog, not bands like Tool, I mean, when you hear like the kind of retro modern prog bands like Transatlantic or the Flower Kings, they definitely have this personality to them that's kind of difficult to match. But Bridge Across Forever is a 10 out of 10 masterpiece album. Four songs on it, and it's like a 75-minute album. I mean, there's Transatlantic, they always do really long ones. 2 26-minute ones at the beginning and the end of the album. So it's one of the best albums ever, and it's one of the absolute best modern prog albums and one of the best prog albums ever. The first album, 70, is really, really good as well, but their latest two albums haven't been as good as those. Next, The Raven That Refused to Sing by Stephen Wilson. This was actually the first Stephen Wilson album I ever bought or listened to. I didn't actually buy any Porcupine Tree albums before I bought this. This was the first one, back in 2016, and I absolutely love it. It's my personal favorite Stephen Wilson album. I think it's better than any Porcupine Tree album or any Stephen Wilson album that he's done. Six songs, they're all amazing. The Raven That Refused to Sing has one of the best music videos of all time, but my personal favorite is Luminol, especially if you listen to it at night time and you maybe go, if you live like somewhere maybe like in the suburbs, or if you live somewhere where you can walk at night and sort of be in a kind of quiet area, that there's not loads of people around or you're not in a dangerous area, go on a walk and listen to this at night time. The whole album, I'd say. Put your earphones on and go on a walk, even in the snow. Last year, it was snowing where I live, and I went out in the snow and listened to this at night time, and it was perfect. It's the perfect album to listen to in the snow at night time. And it was that really kind of light snow where a gust of wind, it's like that kind of powder snow where a gust of wind sort of blows it up into the air. So it was quite eerie as well, which fits this album perfectly. Which is one I really need to review at some point. Next, Five by Spock's Beard. This is one I've talked about before. It's one of the most underrated albums ever. Just right off the bat, The Great Nothing, 27-minute song at the end of the album. One of the greatest songs of all time. Neil Morse. I have my criticisms of Neil Morse over the last maybe 15 years of his music. I feel like he's kind of treading over old ground. But I have to give it to him. He wrote The Great Nothing all by himself, and it's one of the greatest songs of all time. I absolutely love it. And at the end of the day, the 16-minute one at the beginning of the album is another amazing one. Brilliant from start to finish. All on a Sunday is not quite as good as the others, but it is an absolutely amazing album. I know Neil Morse is also in Transatlantic, but it is a different band, so I'm going to count it as a different band. So we're not, that doesn't break the, you know, no more than one album per band rule. So next, Lateralis by Tool. Haven't actually listened to their new album yet. I'm going to buy it on CD, and it's pretty shit that they haven't released a normal CD of it. Like, not everyone wants to buy this £100 special edition. Why can't they just release a £10 CD and let us buy it, you know? So that's kind of shit. But the first four, you've got to give it to Lateralis. You know, The Grudge, Patient, Schism, Parabola, the title track. It's absolutely amazing. They are the definitive progressive metal band, even though they've only released five now. Sorry, I kind of... I've been used to saying they've only released four albums for so long that you kind of forget that they've released five now. But yeah, they've released five albums. First one in 13 years, Fear Inoculum, just came out a couple of months ago. On my birthday, actually. It came out on my birthday. And I can't wait to buy it and listen to it. I'm saving up for it at the moment. Hopefully buy it next month. And I might review it. I don't know. I've got other videos to do. But Lateralis is absolutely amazing, and the vinyl's so cool. If you ever buy the vinyls, get the picture disc and everything, it's awesome. And last but not least, Deadwing, Porcupine Tree. Well, again, it's kind of like Vibe by Spock's Beard. Arriving Somewhere But Not Here is worth the asking price. 12-minute song. It's one of the greatest songs of all time. Absolutely amazing. But you've also got the 9-minute title track. You've got Shallow, Lazarus, Shattering, an Open Car, Mellotron Scratch. It's the best Porcupine Tree album in my opinion. A lot of people say Fear of a Blank Planet or An Absentia, but personally I have to go with Deadwing. Anyway, that's my just a quick, I actually managed to talk about 15 albums and not waffle on for like half an hour, so that's definitely an improvement over my previous videos and stuff. I do have other albums to review by Christmas. I've got a list of about 5 albums that I plan on reviewing by Christmas. So I'll definitely try and do that, and I'll maybe do a video about video games. Even though I won't be showing any footage of video games, I might just kind of talk about them. So that should be kind of fun. Anyway, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed. See you next time.